हेलो, अप टू नाउ इन ब्रेक एंड क्लच वी हैड डिस्कस इन अ प्रीवियस लेक्चर व्हाट इज द ब्रेक्स. वी नो दैट द ब्रेक्स इज द आर्टिफिशियल फ्रिक्शनल रेजिस्टेंस. इस इज अप्लाइड टू द मूविंग मशीन्स एंड मेंबर. सो ब्रेक इज डिवाइस टू retard and stop the motions of the vehicle. So the capacity of the brakes is defined capacity of the brakes is depend on the following factors, in which the unit pressures between the braking surface, coefficient of the friction and velocity of the brake drum, projected area and ability to displace capacity, also concerned with the material of the material for the brake lining material. We had too much discuss about in a previous lecture, and then types of brake in a single shoe brakes, why we use when we use, that is the only where 2 theta is the less than 60, that time we use the single shoe brakes. Okay, now this is the equation Ft equal to mu r and Tb equal to Ft into r. So this is the equation for the brake lining material, and from this SFBM diagram we can find out all the things regarding Ft will be a case number one. Ft will be passing through the fulcrum O, Ft will be passing through the below the O, Ft will be passing through the above the O. From this theory we can find out the one theory, that is the concern with the self locking and self energized brake. So in case number 2 in the clockwise, in the case number 3 in the anti clockwise, rnx equal to pl plus mu rn into a. So moment of frictional force mu rn into a added to the moment of force pl, in other words the frictional force help to the apply the brake. Such types of brake is said to be self energizing brakes. Okay, so when the frictional force is great enough to the apply the brakes, no external force is required for the brake, that is called as a self locking, in which self locking brakes P will be a zero or negative. Okay, now 2 theta is the greater than 60, that time we use the pivoted block, in which mu will be converted into mu dash, that is the call as a equivalent coefficient of the frictions. For in the manners that is called as a 4 mu sin theta divided by 2 theta plus sin 2 theta. Okay, now regarding one example we had covered in the previous lecture, and double shoe brakes is the concern with the it will be used for the overcome the drawback of the single shoe brakes, in which the bending of the shaft is occurred. So we can use the double block or shoe brakes. Okay, up to now we had studies about the all things. Today we will discuss about the another brakes, is the simple bend brakes. Okay, now in these brakes the shoe will be replaced by the bend. Okay, as shown in figure, one end of the bend is attached to the O and another bend is attached to the B. Okay, so this is the distance between O, OB is B, and we can apply the load to the end of the lever in upward directions. Okay, so it is the distance to the L from the fulcrum O. If your drum will be rotated in the clockwise directions, so this is the tight side and this is the slack side. Okay, so this is the tight side and this is the slack side, but if the drum will be rotated in anti-clockwise, so this is the slack, this is the side and this is the slack side. Okay, so that is the basic difference between whenever drum will be rotated in the clockwise and anti clockwise we can use simple bend brakes. Okay, why we use the simple bend brakes, in which the shoe brakes the retard and stop the motions of the vehicle, as compared to the bend and simple bend brakes it not be a sufficient and efficient. Okay, so whenever we apply the brakes, the drum will be rotating in the speed of the above the 350 rpm, 600 rpm, That time we use the simple band and subbricks. This is the simple arrangement of the simple band bricks. Now, up to the now, what we had studied in the single block or subbricks, that is the one equation. Ft equal to mu r, that is the frictional torque equations, and from this equation, Tb equal to Ft into r. So from this equation, we can find out Tb or load. Okay. Now simple band break is concerned with what? That is the T1, tension in the tight side. T2 is the tension in the slack side. We know that drum will be rotated in this direction. That is called as a clockwise tight side. Another is the slack side. This is the tight side. This is the slack side. Okay. Now that is the angle of theta equal to angle of lap. Angle of lap, that means what? The belt is attached to attached with the drum from this to this direction. Okay, so covering of the band, it attached to the drum in portion of the area, that is called the angle of lap. Okay, so we know that mu is the coefficient of the frictions and the radius of the drum and the thickness of the band. Now re is the effective radius of the drum, that is called as r plus t by 2. Okay, whenever in examples we can find out the effective thickness of the drum, that time re, that means what? This is the radius of the drum plus t, that is the thickness of the belt. Okay, so re equal to r plus t by 2. Okay, now we know that the limiting ratio of the tension, that is called as a t1 by t2 equal to e raised to mu theta, or it will be a converted into log, that is the 2.3 log t1 by t2 equal to mu theta. Okay, so and the breaking force on the drum, that is the tight side minus slack side, we can find out the breaking of the drum, and breaking torque on the drum, that is called as a tb equal to t1 minus t2 into r. So in this equation we can neglect a thickness of the band. Now if we considering the thickness of the band, that time t1 minus t2 into re, so re equal to r plus t by 2, that is the call as the thickness will be a considered, it is called as the effective radius of the drum, and also consider that whenever the thickness of the band will be considered, that time tb equal to t1 minus t2 into re, so re equal to r plus t by 2. Now in examples, how can we find the load? So in a simple band breaks, we can taking the moment at the fulcrum O. So in this direction, PL equal P into L and T1 into B. So that is the simple, that is the two load at a distance of B and L will be a concern. So in the breaks, if drum will be rotated in the clockwise direction, that time PL equal to T1 into B and PL equal to T2 into B. Okay. So in examples, if you are in examples, if we can find the load, how much load will be occurred to the retard and stop the motions of the vehicle? So first of all, we can use this equation, that is called as a 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta. Okay, now the breaking of the torque, breaking of the drum, that is called as a Tb. Tb equal to T1 minus T2 into r. So in this equation, we neglect the thickness of the band. But if we considering the thickness of the band, that is called as a T1 minus T2 into re. So re equal to r plus t by 2. Now if drum will be rotated in the clockwise directions, that time taking the moment at O, the PL equal to t1 into b, and anti-clockwise directions PL equal to t2 into b. Now if we design the brakes, that time what is the width and what is the thickness of the band? Okay, so in this regard, how can we calculate the thickness of the band and the width of the band? Whenever we design the load, that time maximum find out a permissible tension for the material, that is the call as the maximum tension in the band. Okay, so suppose that is the T1. Okay, that is the tension in the tight side, that is the maximum tension in the band. So T1 equal to sigma WT. Okay, so sigma, from this equation, T1 equal to sigma WT. So sigma equal to stress for the material and width of the band and thickness of the band, we can find out from this equation width and thickness of the band. Okay, so that is a simple equation, that is a simple phenomena of the differential simple band breaks, in which, what is the simple band breaks we can recall? So we can replace here the SU by using the band. So one end of the band is attached to the O, another band is attached to the B. That is the distance between the O to B is B, and up end of the lever to the O is the L. Okay, drum will be rotated in the clockwise direction. That is the tight side, that is the slack side. And if drum will be rotated in the anti-clockwise, that is the slack side and this is the tight side. Okay, now find out the limiting ratio of the band. That is the relation of the T1 by T2 equal to mu theta, or 2.3 log T1 by T2, 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta. If thickness of the band will be considering in the breaking of torque, that time TB equal to T1 minus T2 into R, and we neglecting the thickness of the band, that time T1 minus T2 into R, but considering the thickness of the band, that time T1 minus T2 into RE, so RE equal to R plus T by 2, and RE equal to R plus T by 2, that means what? It is the effective radius of the drum. So we can find out the RE, from the RE we can find out the breaking torque. Okay, now taking the moment at O, that is PL equal to T1 minus B and PL equal to T2 into B, drum will be rotated in the clockwise and drum will be rotated in the anti-clockwise directions. Okay, now permissible, how can we design the thickness of the band and width of the band? So first of all, find out maximum tension in the band, that is called as a T1. So T1 equal to sigma WT, that is the width of the band and thickness of the band. Okay, from this equation, we can find out the sigma width W and T. Now, a band of the branch, now we had considered here the one examples. In examples, a band breaks act under 3/4 of circumference of the drum of 450 mm diameter, which is keyed to the shaft. Okay, the band act under 3/4 of circumference, that means what? Okay, drum will be a band will be attached in the 3/4 of circumference. Yani ki band is attached up to the 3/4 of the drum. Okay, so that is the basic concept of the 3/4, that is called as a theta, and that is the angle of lap, that is called as a 3/4. Now diameter of the drum, that is the 4/50, and which is keyed to the shaft. The band breaks provide a breaking torque of 2 to 5 newton into meter, that is called as a TB. Okay, now one end of the band is attached to the fulcrum pin of the lever, and another end to the P 100 mm. So in this equation, that is called as a B. So one end is here and another is here, so this is called as a B, that is the 100 mm. Okay, now if the operating force is applied at the 500 mm from the fulcrum, yani ki n pe we can apply the load 500 mm from the fulcrum, that is called as a L. Okay, and the coefficient of the frictions is 0.25, here mu equal to 0.25. find the operating force when the drum is rotating in the clockwise and anticlockwise. In this example, we can find out that is called as a P, okay, at the end of the lever. So if drum will be rotated in the clockwise as well as drum will be rotated in the anti-clockwise. So first of all, how can we solve this example? We know that P will be a constant in a difference simple band breaks. PL equal to T1 into B, PL equal to T2 into B. That is the two equations for the find out clockwise and anti-clockwise directions of the drum. Okay, so in this example, B and L is given. B and L is given for the clockwise and anti-clockwise. T1 and T2 is not given. So first of all, we can solve the T1 and T2. So first of all, theta equal to 3/4 of circumference. So according to the 360 degree, we can convert the into the degree, that is called a 270 degree. That is the circumference of the drum. It will be a connected the band to the drum. Okay, now 270 degree to the, it will be a converted into π/180. So that is the radian, theta equal to 4.713 radian. Now we know that what is the limiting ratio. So limiting ratio is the 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta. Okay, From this equation, mu is given, theta is given. From this equation, we find out the TB, T1 by T2 ratio, that is called as a 3.25. Now, in the example, TB is given. TB is concerned with the TB equal to T1 minus T2 into R. So from this equation, T1 minus T2 equal to 100 Newton, we can find out. And equation 1, that is T1 by T2 equal to 3.25, and equation 2, T1 minus T2 equal to 1000. From these two equations, we can find out 10 T1 and T2. So T1 equal to 1444 and T2 equal to 344. Okay. So now we can put here this value of T1 and T2 into clockwise and anti-clockwise. In a clockwise direction, PL equal to T1 into B. So that is called as a T2 into B. So P equal to 88.8 Newton. Now drum will be rotated in the anti-clockwise direction. That time PL equal to T1 into B. So we can put here the equation, T1 value in this equation, and P equal to 228.8. Okay. So that is the simple examples of the simple Venn brakes. In example of the simple Venn brakes, there is the three equations is required. First of all is a 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta. That is the call as a limiting ratio of the band. And now TB equal to T1 minus TB equal to T1 minus T2 into R. So we can find out from these two equations, we can find out the T1 and T2 value. Okay. So put this TPBL equal to T2 into B and T2 into B and T1 into B. So for the clockwise and anti-clockwise, and we can find out how much load will be accepted on the end of the lever. Okay. So that is the basic example of the simple Venn brakes. Now, this is the another examples. In this example, the simple Venn brakes as shown in figure is applied to the shaft carrying a wheel of the mass 400 kg. Okay. And the radius of the gyrations of the wheel is 450 mm. It runs at 300 RPM. Okay. So in this figure, so there is the basic difference between the simple Venn brakes and this brake. This is also called as a simple Venn brakes. But here we can attach the one end of the band is to the A and another band of the attached to the O. Okay. So how much that is the concern OA, this is the B, O2A, this is the B, but it is the on the left side, but in this example, this is the right side. It's 120 mm. Okay. The radius of gyrations of the wheel is 450 mm at the 300 RPM. If the coefficient of the frictions is 0.2, okay, yani mu is given here 0.2, and the brake drum diameter is 240 mm, find the torque applied due to the hand load of 100 Newton. Okay, so we can apply 100 Newton load at the end. That time, what is the torque? Okay, and second thing is that the number of turns of the wheel before it is bring to rest. Okay. Whenever we apply the loads by using the hand, that time up to the zero, okay, that time how much it will be a turn to wheel before it's bring to in a zero positions, okay, in the zero mode, okay. And third one is that at the time required to bring to rest for the moment of the applications of the brakes. So we can find out here from the T, okay. From this example, the mass is given. Here, that is the 400 kg, and radius of gyrations, that is the 450 mm, and RPM is given, that is the call as a 300 RPM. So from this equation, we can find out the omega 2 pi n by 60, and mu is given, okay? So first of all, we can find out the torque applied due to the load, okay? So torque applied to load, that is called as a TB. So TB equal to T1 minus T2 into R. But here in this example, how can we find out the theta? Theta is here the 90. Your band is attached to the here. Okay. So 360 minus 150. Okay. From this figure, we can say that 90 plus 60, that is the 150. And theta equal to, that is the angle of lap. the angle of left equal to 360 minus 150. Okay, so from this equation we can find out the theta, and theta equal to 200 from this equation from the theta we can find out in the radian, that is 3.66. Now we know that the what is the limiting ratio, that is the 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta. From this equation we can find out the T1 minus T2 ratio. Okay, now taking the moment at O, about the fulcrum O, so we can find out the O. So here T2 is concerned with the 120, okay, and 100 into 300, this is the distance of the drum. So we can taking the moment, so T2 into 120 equal to PL, that is called as a PL, that is the concern with the L is 300 and P equal to 100. So from this equation we can find out the T2 value. Okay, so T2 equal to 250 and T1 equal to 520. Okay, and we know that what is the limiting ratio, TB equal to T1 minus T2 into R. So we can put the value T1 minus T2 into R and we can find out the TB. Okay, now another case is concerned with what? A number of turns of the wheel before it's brought to rest. Yani, first of all, we know that what is the omega. Omega is concerned with the 31.42 radian per second. Okay, so now tension, that is the find the tension in the tight side and slack side, T1 and T2 respectively. So in this tight side to slack side and slack side to tight side in the clockwise anti-clockwise direction. So first of all, we can find out the how much kinetic energy of rotation of the drum. So in this example, the mass of the drum as well as radius of gyrations is given. So 1/2 I omega square. So 1/2 m k square omega square, we can I equal to m k square. From this equation, we can find out the how much kinetic energy will be occurred in the wheel, that is the 14,000 newton into meter. Now, kinetic energy equal to TB into 2 pi n. From this equation, we can find out the rotation of the drum. Okay, so TB is we can find out from the T1 minus T2 into R, and from the rotation of the drum, the n is the 196.5. Yani, number of turns of the wheel before it's come to rest, it will be a turn 196.5 turn. Okay, now time required to bring to rest, we know that it will be a run 196.5, and drum rotations is the 300 rpm. So n by n, that we from this equation we can find out 0.655 minutes and around the 40 second. So this is the criteria for the, we can find out from the this equation, that is the concern with the time required to come to bring to rest, that is the 40 second. Okay, so this is the simple examples of the drum. Now third one is the simple band brakes operated on the drum of 600 meter in the diameter. I this one is the concern with the 600 diameter. Okay, now that is a diameter that is the running at the 200 rpm. okay, the drum will be running at the 200 rpm. The coefficient of the friction is 0.25. now the brake band has the contact of 270 degree. One end is fastened to the fixed pin and another is the another end to the brake arm 125. We know that from this figure we can find out that that is the 125 and 750, that is the fastened to the fixed pin to the another pin is the 125 fixed pin. The straight brakes 25 long and placed perpendicular to the diameter and bisect the angle of contact. Now first of all, what is the pull necessary on the end of the brakes arm to stop wheel is 35 kilowatt is being absorbed. And again, power will be absorbed, that is the 35 kilowatt. What is the directions of the pull? This minimum pull. Okay, so here in this example, what is the pull in direction? It is upward and this is the downward, that is the we can solve in the example, but in solution we can say that there is the downward force, that is the upward force. But when the arm stop is bring to 35 kilowatt is to be absorbed. Okay, now what width of the steel band 2.5 meter thick is required for these brakes if the maximum tensile stress is not to exceed 5 newton per meter square. Okay, so in this example, we can find out the P as well as width of the band, also thickness of the band. Okay. Now in solution, the given data is the D, that is the diameter of the drum. So R equal to 300 mm and N equal to 200 rpm and mu equal to 0.25 and theta equal to 270 degree and theta equal to 478 radian. Now power is the 35 kilowatt and 350 into 10 raised to 3 watt and thickness of the band is given here 2.5 and maximum permissible tension stress equal to 50 newton per meter square, mm square. Okay. Now how can we solve this? First of all, the pull necessary on the band of the brake is arm to stop the wheel. Okay. The simple, in a simple band brakes as shown in figure, we know that 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta. Okay. So first of all, we can find out the limiting ratio, that is called as a T1 by T2 equal to 3.25. Okay. Now power is P, we know that P equal to 2 pi NT by 60, that is called as a TB, that is called as a torque. So torque is concerned with the 2 pi into N equal to 200 RPM. So TB equal to 1169 10 raised to 3. Okay. So now we know that what is the TB? TB equal to T1 minus T2 into R. So from this equation, we can find out the T1 minus T2 into R. Okay. So from equation 1 and equation 2, we can find out the T1 and T2 value. Okay. Up to the now, we had studies that limiting ratio is the 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta. And from this equation, we can find out the T1 and T2 ratio. And this is the 3.25. And power will be 2 pi NT by 60. And that is called as a TB. TB equal to 60 and TB equal to 1667 into 10 raised to 3 Newton into mm. And we know that what is the braking torque, TB equal to T1 minus T2 into R. From this equation 1 and equation 2, we can find out the T1 and T2 value. Okay, now our torque 6 watt. Now taking the moment at O. Now taking the moment at O and taking the distance that is called as a P into L and also concerned with the T2 into 125. Okay, so we can from this taking the moment at O and from this equation we can out the P, that is the 290 Newton. Okay, so now another task is what is the width of the steel band? Width of the steel band, that means what? We know that in a theory, so what maximum permissible tension, that is called as a T1. Okay, here maximum is the 8025. Okay, 8025 into sigma WT. From this equation, sigma is given 50, T is given 2.5, and from this equation, we can find out the 64.25 mm. This is the width of the band. Okay, so from this, in a simple band brakes, only two equations is given to find out the T1 and T2 value, 2.3 log T1 by T2. And another is the TB equal to T1 minus T2 into R. From these two equations, we can find out the T1 and T2 value. And our task is what? Load. How can we solve the load? If the drum will be rotated in the clockwise directions, that time PL equal to T2 into B. If the drum will be rotated in anti-clockwise directions, PL equal to T1 into B. Okay. So from these three equations, we can find out the load. But in examples, given to the find out to the width and the thickness of the band, that time the permissible tension in the band, that is called as a T1 and sigma WT. And from this equation, we can find out the width of the band. Okay. So that is the basic of the simple, that this is a simple example of the simple band brakes. Now, another topic is the concern with the differential band brakes. Okay. Now, what is differential band brakes? You can see in the figure. Okay, this is the modifications of the simple band brakes. This is called as a differential band brakes, in which in a simple band brakes, we can attach the one end of the band is connected to the O, another is the connected with the B. Okay, this is the simple criteria. Now in these brakes, we can extend the lever that is called as O to A. and this is the distance A. Okay, so we can find out the we can say that this is the distance between O to A, and this is the tight side and this is the slack side. This is the also tight side and this is the slack side. If the drum will be rotated in the clockwise and anti-clockwise. Okay, so here in a simple band breaks we can find out the equations PL equal to T1 into B and PL equal to T2 into B for the clockwise and anti-clockwise directions of the drum. Okay, now in the differential band breaks there is the three load and three distance P into L, T1 into B and T2 into A for the clockwise. In the anti-clockwise PL D2 into B, T1 into B, T1 into A for the anti-clockwise. Now, in a differential band breaks, how can we solve it? Okay, taking the moment at O. Okay, drum will be rotated in the clockwise direction. That is called as a clockwise. That is also concerned with the clockwise. Okay, that is also concerned with the anti-clockwise. So, PL equal to T1 into B equal to T2 into B from the taking the moment at O. Okay. So PL equal to T2 into A minus T1 into B. This is the equation for the clockwise rotation of the drum. Now, PL taking the moment at O in the anti-clockwise direction rotation of the drum. So PL, okay? So PL equal to T1 into A minus T2 into B for the anti-clockwise directions. Okay, that is the simplest form of differential band breaks equation. Okay, but in which the limiting ratio is the 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta. It is also concerned with the differential band breaks. And TB equal to T1 minus T2 into R. But whenever we find the P, that is called as a load in clockwise and anti-clockwise direction, that time we use PL equal to T2 into A minus T1 into B and PL equal to T1 into A minus T2 into B. This is the equations for the drum will be rotation in the clockwise and anti-clockwise. Now, here, as shown in figure, that is the one examples, in a differential band breaks, as shown in figure as the angle of contact, that is called as a angle of flap and angle of contact, theta is a 250. The band is compressed woven lining with the bear against the cast iron drum, 350 mm diameter. The diameter of the drum is 350 mm. The brake is sustained a torque of 350 newton into meter. Torque, that means what? This is the TB. TB equal to 350 newton into meter. And the coefficient of the frictions between band and drum is 0.3. Okay. So 0.3 is the mu. First of all, in first case, the necessary force P for the clockwise and anti-clockwise rotation of the drum. Okay. First of all, we can find out the P. If drum will be rotated in the clockwise, if drum will be rotated in anti-clockwise. Now, another is the value of OA for the brake to self-locking when the drum is rotated in the clockwise. So we can consider only here this figure. From this figure, we can say that if the drum will be rotated in the clockwise, that is the OA. OA is the 150. It's the self-locking. Okay. In a first lecture, we know that in a brake and clutch, we know that what is the self-locking. If the P will be a zero or negative, that time these types of brake is called as a self-locking brake. So in which OA will be a zero or negative, so that time we will consider in the self-locking brake. Okay. Now we can see the solutions of these types of brakes. Okay. Now necessary pull of the clockwise and anti-clockwise. We know that what is 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta. From this equation, we can find out that is the ratio of the T1 by T2 equal to 3.25. And TB equal to T1 minus T2 into R. From this equation, we can find out the T1 and T2 value. Okay. We know that what is the value of the PL. PL equal to T2 into B minus T1 in T2 into A minus T1 into B. From this equation, we can find out the P as well as in the anti-clockwise directions, PL equal to T1 into A minus T2 into B. From this equation, find out the P. Okay. So in a simple mandrakes and differential mandrakes, what is the difference? That is only equation difference. Okay, for the find out the P. So PL equal to T1 into B for the clockwise, PL equal to T2 into B for the anti-clockwise, for the simple difference, simple mandrakes. In differential mandrakes, 3 will be concentrated because we can extend that O to A distance here to the find out a value of PL. So the equation will be converted into the PL equal to T1 into B minus T2 into B, T2 into A minus T2 into A, T2 into B. Okay. So that is the basic equations for the clockwise and anti-clockwise, but procedure is same. 2.3 log T1 by T2 mu theta. From this equation, find out T1 and T2 values. So breaking torque TB equal to T1 minus T2 into R. So T1 minus T2 into R, from this equation, we can find out the T1 and T2 value. And now P is now drum will be rotated into clockwise direction. That time P equal, we can find out the P if drum will be rotated in anti-clockwise direction. From this equation, we can find out the P. Okay. Now value of OA for the brake to be a self-locking when the drum rotated in the clockwise direction. If the drum will be rotated in the clockwise direction, but the condition is self-locking, we know that what is the self-locking brake. In self-locking brake, P will be a negative or zero. So we can find out PL equal to T2 into A. So self-locking equation PL equal to T2 into A minus T1 into B. But here OA is zero. So equation will be converted into the, and load will be a zero. So P equal to zero. So T2 into A equal to T1 into OB. So OA equal to T1 into OB by T2. So OA equal to 1144 mm. So whenever in example, the self-locking conditions will be a given, that time you can put P equal to zero or negative. So we can find out we can say that is the concern with the self-locking brakes. Okay. Now, this is the one examples. How can we solve this? Differential band brakes. This is the differential band brakes, 3/4 of the circumference of the drum of 450 mm diameter, and provide the braking torque TB equal to 22 mm. Theta is given here 3/4, and drum will be a diameter is this 450 mm, and TB equal to 225 Newton into meter. One end of the attached to the pin 100 mm, that is called as a A. And B is given here 25. From this fulcrum side is where the operating force is acting. If the operating force is applied 500 mm from the fulcrum, okay, so that is called as a L. And coefficient of the frictions is given, that is called as a mu. Mu equal to 0.25. Find the value of the operating force two directions, clockwise and anti-clockwise. We know that first of all, PL equal to T2 into A minus T2 into B. PL equal to T1 into A minus T2 into B for the clockwise and anti-clockwise directions equation. L is given, A is given, B is given. So first of all, find out T1 and T2. So how can we solve this example? First of all, 2.3 log T1 by T2. From this equation, find out the T1 and T2 value. TB is given. TB equal to T1 minus T2 into R. So from this equation 1 and 2, we can find out T1 and T2 value. And put this equation in the PL equal to T1 into A minus T2 into B, and PL equal to T2 into A minus T1 into B. You can solve this example from this equation, and this is the answer for the clockwise. This is called as a this is 16.6 and 226.6 for the anti-clockwise. Okay. So now today we will stop here, and from the next class, in the next lecture, we will discuss about the band and block brakes. Okay. Thank you very much.